You're still watching Waze. Today is International Monkey Day. Celebrated on December 14th on an annual basis, Monkey Day is a holiday that celebrates monkeys as well as other non-human primates, such as apes, and also known as International Monkey Day. This day is used in raising awareness and about these animals and their role in nature. So we just leave it at that.
Well, I would. I really like the idea because you know they're a bit close to us.
They're close to who?
Humans.
Monkeys are
close.
They're what?
No, you can have them as pets. Yes.
No, not me.
Have you ever lived in the north?
You pass.
No. Oh, they have. I mean, I was born in Jos.
Yeah, because if you've lived in the north, you would know that they.
So you're at one with monkeys. Is that what you're telling?
Yeah, like you would have pets. You know.
Right.
You can have a beautiful monkey.
You too.
No way.
You said we are related to them now.
Yes. Yeah, so we should celebrate them.
Okay. Happy monkeys.
They are so pretty. Are you not saying that? They're so cute. You don't so happy use, international
maybe
monkey
cute,
day.
Not pretty.
Oh, it's a cute one.
All right. So, Lami, let's go with you first. What did you find for us?
Okay. What I found in the news is about the Turkish Airlines.
Okay.
The government threatened to suspend their services, and guess what happened? You know, there's this matter has been on for years, this pertaining to their lackadaisical manner of treating
customer
service. Then, particularly passengers return to Nigeria without their luggages. 85% of the luggages are left behind in Turkey. It means that they do not have the capacity to ferry those luggages, but they still take them on. So what they do is they bring them in beats. So it means that it's either they're using substandard planes
to ferry
people.
For when it comes to Nigerian
small
things, right?
People yes.
just sort of decide to give us.
So why particular? I was particular about the story is that Nigerian government stood up for Nigerians.
Hallelujah. That's
and
great to know.
You know, the response was very swift. In 24 hours, they resolved everything. They even promised to change the planes up.
Which goes to show that they knew what was going on. I'm sure nobody complained.
You know, so what I can take from this is that I think the government should do this more.
Absolutely. I agree.
So it means that we can get results.
But not just
many more airlines.
But I know that for a fact that because most times when I travel and I need to now change my airplane,
the plane is
the
always
aircraft
bigger and better.
Always beautiful, different.
Same experience.
Why?
I've had the same
Why
experience.
Do we have that? Because of our wrong ways as well. So you really cannot blame these airlines when they don't bring those Airbus, you know, those
A380
those
does
big
not
ones.
Fly Nigerian.
Because our runway capacity can't handle some of these aircrafts.
Why
so
can't
it's not
it
just
handle?
It's not just saying that I like the fact that they are standing up for Nigerians, but I also want them.
But we don't. They don't have an enabling environment.
Let's build a world class airport, please. Mm. Let us upgrade.
Okay,
we have the money.
We do.
We do have the money.
They bring small planes to Nigeria.
Yeah, because that sometimes they are also thinking that is what can. They don't want to spoil their aircraft. No. Mm. Do you understand?
So when you now have a connecting, have a connecting flight from Turkey, they bring out the big ones.
Yeah, they're not coming to Nigeria.
I was so impressed that they came hands in cheek, like we'll do everything.
Because they know that we have a lot of revenue.
Of course,
generation from that.
Yeah, they're generating from Nigeria.
Commercial activity. There's a lot of commercial activity.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah, Nasa. So that's up to you next.
Okay. Well, so moving on to something that is actually a bit sad. You know, a couple weeks ago, a lady was rushed to hospital. She had been stabbed, and she got to the hospital. They didn't treat her because allegedly there was no police report. So the Nigerian police first have come out to restate that no medical facility should request for a police report or clearance before treating any gunshot victim or knife stab victim.
Wound,
And the president of the National Medical Association has also corroborated that, saying that the doctors have a directive to actually attend to such victims, and then they're duty bound to report to the police whilst that treatment is going on, or whilst once the victim has been stabilized.
Nasa, do you know actually it's not even a directive, it's a law.
Oh, okay.
There's a law, the Compulsory Treatment and Care for Victims of Gunshot Act 2017. that mandates that every government facility or health facility mm-hmm. must admit first, administer medication.
First before
then ongoing, when that is ongoing, you make a reference, you make a report to the police.
And, but you and should even have done that first aid first.
Even
exactly,
part of
get
the law,
stabilized.
And part of the law says that it's bound, they are bound to admit without any deposit.
But there's a lot of shroudiness around, what's her name, Moradi?
That's
her
Moradi name. Balogun.
You know, there's a lot of shroudiness around her story.
The different
because, the hospital are coming out to say that they were not equipped to be able to handle the area where that wound was very delicate. So yes. They were not equipped to handle that case. But some other people are saying no, that it was
they demanded for
police reports.
Well, you know, someone that came in shouting that was able to speak when she got to your hospital.
She actually called her dad.
Do you understand?
And said, "Daddy, I am dying. Please come."
Oh my goodness!
And her dad made that trip in 40 minutes, so she was still alive for 40 minutes.
Oh my God.
So something could have been done. She died in the arms of her parents.
You look at. Do you know what? You see, you
watch
all these emergency room programs in these developed countries. And you see, like, cases where you think the person should have died and they're able to do something.
You know, there was one I watched.
Just yesterday, I was watching a video on Instagram. A young girl in China, there was an 81-year-old man that slumped at the train station. She's a medical student. She's not even a doctor yet.
She did the CPR.
She was there on him for some couple of minutes until the man was resuscitated.
Yeah.
And the family of the girl offered of the man offered the girl money. She said no, that it's her duty
bound.
Because she's a medical student.
Oath they've taken.
That is she is a medical. She's not even taking that oath.
Can you imagine?
She is a doctor. So. You see, it is just the value for human life. And
absolutely.
We need to. So for us in Nigeria, it's beyond just saying, oh, I cannot handle
caring
this.
For your neighbor.
Just humanity.
That
human face.
Human
and
nature.
I think we've lost that from the hospital. So just, it's just about, you know, if you don't have the money. If you
will
don't
I call my own story on a lighter note or on a serious
okay, please,
note.
On a
first
lighter
of, first of all, Donald Trump has been, because I couldn't just help it. I had to go international.
International.
Donald Trump has been all over the news. You know, I've been watching CNN all morning. He's been all over the news, you know, talking about the young girl, Greta Thunberg, that was named Times People Person of the Year.
Well,
and he was mocking the girl, you know. You know, this girl, she's been an activist on climate change.
Climate change.
And, you know, we clearly see that there's a lot of things happening in climate change. And I'm happy that a lot of people, like the First Lady, Michelle Obama, has come out to support her. And she is taking it lightly because he's tweeted something very sarcastic about her. So what she did, she just changed her status on her Twitter page and said, yeah, she's chilling with her friends and she's having a drink. Because he's saying that she should go for anger management. I said, how can the president,
he doesn't realize that climate change is a fundamental right of a child.
No, he doesn't.
Because we're leaving that climate for the next generation.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So she has to.
And she's saying it.
She's
she's protecting her future.
Absolutely.
And talking about climate change, I think Nigerians, we need to wake up. Because when we hear climate change,
we think it's very foreign. It's close to home.
Because look at how the climate, our weather conditions is.
It's no longer raining.
So we don't even know what season we're in right now, you know. And people, for goodness sake, I was driving yesterday when I was coming to the to the studio. I saw a man in an SUV
throwing out
a big chunk of non-degradable plastic into the lagoon. And I'm wondering, are you even?
And they are the first set of people to start calling out the government.
We all have a role to play. But we'll leave it at that. That's all we can take on what's in the news. Up next, we have Rita Okoye joins us as we dive into today's discussion. Stay with us, we'll be right back.